especially feel for these big cats because we as humans have put them here in the US. They don't belong here. It's people who have done them wrong that have done all this to them. And so I just feel like I want to do my best to make right on behalf of my species for their species.
It's been a dream. The world sort of slows down for me. There's one particular cat, Kaya, and she will come up to me and she'll lay down in front of me and we just stare at each other. Oh, sweetness. There's sweet Kaya. And we just breathe together, and it's one of my most favorite things to do, is to just be in the moment and hear the cats and see them happy and just be.
I've always wanted to work with animals because they can't speak for themselves. Exotic Feline Rescue Center. So we rescue exotic cats from abandoned, abused, neglected situations.
You say hi?
Most people don't realize that there are more big exotic cats in the US than there are usually in their wild counterparts. A lot of them come from the private trade, pet trade, fur trade, meat trade, just breeding babies for profit. But we are basically a home for those guys.
I was very nervous to start my senior thesis. It's very daunting, but I have loved getting to know the cats. We each have a cohort of cats that we'll observe, and just learning their behaviors, learning their idiosyncrasies, their quirks. Some of them are really friendly. Some of them are a little more aloof. I love being out here with them and seeing them happy.
It feels so nice because you feel like you're sort of welcomed in their home, because this feels like this is more animal-centered. This isn't necessarily human-centered.
Hi, Lily. Hello, honey.
Hi, Lily.
Hi, baby. How are you?
They really give you this feeling of contentment and that they're happy and, again, well-fed, and, again, they're chuffing at you, and it really gives you the sense that this is a place where they feel safe and secure. And
how are you, baby? Honey.
So we have 143 cats, and about 100 of those cats are tigers.
We are monitoring the effects of enrichment on cortisol levels in a population of captive felids in Center Point, Indiana. And we are doing that using fecal samples. So we collect those every day.
The not so glamorous part of my thesis is the fecal analysis. And it doesn't smell the best. It's not the most glamorous work.
We actually are going through and administering pumpkins so that they have a chance to have some sort of positive enrichment. Some of the girls are going to be getting regular chicken. Some are getting their chicken delivered in pumpkins, and that gives them some sort of a toy to play with. And we're going to see if that actually has an effect on their cortisol levels. In addition, we're going to go through and take some of their fecal samples and culture them to look and see what kind of bacteria they have growing in their gut.
Dr. Doyle has generously allowed us to use her van to process it. So we get to dig through the poop and separate it into different vials and tubes.
These guys are actually fed a diet that consists predominantly of chicken or ungulates, so cows, horses, and so forth. And so that's a pretty good simulation of a wild diet. And so we want to see how close they come to an actual wild microbiome. And we're also going through and freezing some samples just in case we can do some DNA microanalysis in the future.
The more research we have about these big cats, the better. It's so hard to study them in the wild. Even though these guys are different from the wild counterparts, it's great to have that huge sample size. I just hope that all this research that can be done to help them in whatever way, behavioral or medical, is going to help the population at large.
That's the hope, is to help these cats stay healthy.
This gives us the opportunity to give back, and we can give back to this rescue center that's really trying to do the best for these animals. So I think it's really just a great project on both sides.
It's a very self-sacrificing job. You don't get into animal work for the money or the fame. you do it because you like bettering their lives. Picking up poop every day, scrubbing out heavy water tanks, wearing a mask in 110 degree heat index, because I love these guys and I just want them to have a good life.